wanted an opinion on this situation. My mom was in a nursing home. She had a couple little falls, ended up in the hospital, so we thought it best that she just come to our house. After about a month, we found out she had pneumonia. That's why she had fallen at the other nursing home. In the hospital, they had to put a peg tube in. We kept her here long enough where we tried to handle that but couldn't, you know, very well. She ended up at another nursing home here closer to us. They actually harassed us about certain things. Like, I would go over there, notice she hadn't gotten out of bed, you know, most of the day. I would go in the morning and in the afternoon. I asked them, you know, nicely, just, I'm worried about bed sores and her just laying there. Can y'all get her up, you know, put her in the wheelchair? You know, activity. There's an activity room. I actually played guitar for them there. They would say, well, you know, she gives us a hard time. She doesn't want to get out of bed. So, well, you know, can you help? I'll come over there. Well, they would. I would go over there and they'd get her up, and we'd be in the activity room, and I'd go home a little bit. They would call me and say, your mom's whining. She's just fussing. She wants to lay down. Would it be okay to lay her down? I mean, you know, with a tone of voice, because I had asked them to get her up. And I'd say, of course, you know, lay her down if she's uncomfortable. But, you know, it was just certain things like that. They kept, you know, doing things. And like I said, toward the end there, she had a peg tube, so her mouth was real dry. We had to find stuff ourselves. There was a spray mist you could buy to moisten her mouth. They weren't even doing that. They wouldn't brush her teeth. I would go over there, and her mouth would just be gummed up. It was just an awful treatment of her. And they seemed to, like I said, be not just neglectful, but had bad opinions of us for trying to take care of her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I'm assuming you kind of get similar phone calls.
Yes. So unfortunately, this does happen quite often. And in this situation, it sounds like your best bet right now, probably you can make file a complaint with the Alabama Department of Health. Actually, you can do that online, or you can give them a call and do that. And that might be the first step in making sure that whatever is going on gets remedied. But any nursing home facility does have the responsibility to make sure your loved one is not dehydrated, that they are take steps to prevent bed sores. So they have a duty to do all those things. So you would be absolutely in the right to expect that.
Yeah, and one thing I think you have to expect is when you go in, when you sign a loved one into a nursing home, they give you a bill of rights, or at least they should. And that sets out basically the tone of what should happen. Now, if something like what you're talking about, Anastasia, suggests, yes, you can contact the Department of Health and Human Resources, file a complaint. You can also talk with the nursing home administrator, and that you have to proactively kind of force your issues with them. You know, they say this squeaky wheel gets a grease. Mm-hmm. You know, you can be a squeaky wheel. You know, you have good nursing homes, and you have nursing homes that are probably trying to be good, and then you have others. And the problem is you have a lot of transient workers there, mm-hmm. and so, you know, the ones that are really good keep their people and for a long time, and they're career people, and those are going to be the ones where you want your loved ones in. And unfortunately, not everybody can be in that nursing home, so you end up in these others where you have, you know, transient workers who may be there today and tomorrow, and they may not be there on the weekend. So, you know, you just kind of have to take it. Being there is the most important thing. Visiting is the most important thing.
Well, any tips, because I know we're about out of time now in the show, but any tips on searching and finding the right place to put your loved one?
So actually, the Medicare website actually has a really good comparison tool. So you can look at different facilities and compare right there on the internet. And that's, again, and also, you know, ask around, ask your friends, ask your doctors, people like that. So.
Figure out which ones get sued the most and which ones don't get sued. I mean, that's the way that we look at, you know, how
good
a quality of care.
How does the average person find that?
Well, they could probably just have to call lawyers and ask, and we can look that up for them.